I know I can't go wherever the wind blows. This much I do know. Though darkness may blind you, I'll come and find you. You know that it's so. And when I'm lonely, you are the only answer I see. And when I'm weary, whenever you're near me, I know that I am free.
Welcome to our Love Stream service of the River of Brass Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Davie, Florida, where we're meeting online today to keep one another safe as the COVID-19 pandemic transitions to endemic status. It's not over, and neither are we. Still here, still together, still continuing to go and grow and flow the river way. And so happy to remind you that we will be meeting both in person and here online for our dual platform on the first Sundays of the month. It is so good to be together this morning. I'm Audrey Stang, and my pronouns are her and she and hers. In this congregation, it is our mission to nurture our spirits, love intentionally, and create a just and healthy planet in our enduring search for truth, meaning, and faith. What we share here is not an unchanging dogma, but an affirmation that we're called to be agents of love and justice, and to build a world where everyone is cherished for who they are. It's our mission and the bonds of beloved community that lights our way through this time of uncertainty and change. So, however you made your way among us this morning, we welcome you, whoever you are, however you are, wherever you are. We welcome you as you are and promise never just to leave you there. So let's pause and enter into this time together as we connect again with one another, with the holy by any name, and with the light of love within us all. Let's take some deep breaths, mindful that not everyone can breathe easily or find it easy to breathe.
This morning, we take another look at what it means to nurture beauty, to be a people who cultivate and nurture beauty in all things. We begin with remembering that beauty is our birthright, that beauty is everyone's birthright, as claimed here in the words of the Reverend Rebecca Savage. Sometimes we awake in the morning with a heaviness in our chest. Sometimes we awake in the morning with the endless to-do list rattling through our thoughts, the nagging reminders of what was left undone yesterday, and the pangs of I'll have to do it all again today, pinching at our insides. Sometimes we awake in the morning and we'd rather go back to sleep. We would rather escape under the covers, a rock, the bottom of the closet, and then the first sliver of sunshine may dance across our face, beautiful. And then the waiting scent of a new day may glide over us, beautiful. And then signs of life blossom around us to include inside of us. Beautiful. Beauty is our birthright, just as we are born in love, through love, and to love.
How could anyone ever tell you you were anything less than beautiful? How could anyone ever tell you you were less than the whole? How could anyone fail to notice that your loving is a miracle? How deeply you're connected to my soul.
We've learned a thing to do during COVID. We call it humbling. We hum and mumble while we relearn our ways of singing together and the words to the things we cherish.
How could anyone ever tell you you were anything less than beautiful? How could anyone ever tell you you were less than the whole?
For all that lies behind, for all that lies before, for all that lies within, we kindle this flame to light the way.
In the light of love, let us renew our covenant as we say together. Love is the spirit of this congregation, and service is its law. This is our great covenant, to dwell together in peace, to seek the truth in love, and to help one another.
El amor es el espíritu de esta congregación y el servicio su ley principal. Esta es nuestra gran promesa, vivir juntos en paz, buscar la verdad a través del amor y ayudarnos mutualmente.
Gonna keep on moving forward, keep on moving forward, keep on moving forward, never turning back, never turning back. Sigamos adelante, siempre adelante, siempre adelante, sin volver atrás, sin volver atrás.
Gonna keep on loving boldly. Keep on loving boldly. Keep on loving boldly. Never turning back. Never turning back.
Amaremos con pasión.
Siempre con pasión. Con pasión, sin volver atrás, sin volver atrás.
Gonna reach across our border,
reach across our border, reach across our border. Never turning back, never
vivamos sin frontera.
Siempre sin frontera. Siempre sin frontera. Sin volver atrás. Sin volver atrás.
Gotta reunite the family.
Reunite the family.
Reunite the family.
Reunite the family.
Never turning back.
Turning back.
Familias reunidas.
Siempre reunidas.
Siempre reunidas.
Sin volver atrás.
Sin volver atrás.
Gonna keep on.
Never turning back, never turning back.
Peace.
We love you.
In our community each week, we share pieces of our lives. This too takes on a new form for our new normal. We take a moment here with people who love us for exactly who we are, where we are right now. So if you'd like to share a thought, a prayer, a joy, or a concern with us in this moment, we'll open our chat space now. You can write it there and we'll lift them up together.
Let us take a breath here as we receive these things that are entrusted to us in this community, knowing that when we share our burdens, they are lightened, and when we share our joys, they are amplified and multiplied. Let us also be mindful of Buffalo, New York, this morning, after yet another mass shooting. In the name of white supremacy. May our thoughts go to that community and to those families, as well as for our own, knowing that it happens to us all as human family. Let's take a moment of silence to take in these things into our hearts. And we thank you all for bringing your lives to us. Source of all, called by many names, none of which we can fully know nor understand, we come this morning asking to be brave enough to let our hearts be seen, even as we become more courageous in learning to see hearts. We bring these concerns for healing and health of body, mind, and spirit that have been brought to us this morning. We ask that our thoughts, our love, our healing energy, our encouragement travel to, surround, and sustain those we love. And also those whom we do not know, but who share our plight as human beings on this planet. Our thoughts are with Ukraine Our thoughts are with the city of Buffalo. Our thoughts are with women all over the United States who are uncertain how their future will now lie, and for families now uncertain of being able to sustain their integrity, their independence, their health and well-being. May we be a force for good in all of these things. May we do more than send our thoughts and prayers. May we be a people so bold as to move this world forward. All these things we lift in the name of all that is holy. Amen, 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 aho, ashe, namaste. Blessed be, and may it be so.
Thank you for that, Ravini. Our announcements this morning are, at River of Brass, we offer many ways to live our Unitarian Universalist faith in action. You'll find them in our weekly email, our Facebook page, and website, riverofbrassuu.org. Here are some upcoming opportunities to fulfill the mission and vision of this congregation and other announcements for the life of this beloved community. First off, for those of you who are new to River of Brass, we welcome you. Please visit our website and fill out a visitor form so that we can provide you with more information about this beloved community. This morning in our faith development class for children, we reflect on appreciating and celebrating beauty in others. Our diversity is what makes us all so beautiful, including our diverse ways of thinking and working. Just as there's no such thing as normal, there is no definitive idea of what beauty is. And Susie is back. This fabulous UU summer camp for families of all ages will meet this summer during the third week of July at Western Carolina University, which is in the foothills of beautiful Blue Ridge Mountains. All participants are asked to be vaccinated and test negative at registration, so that we can gather safely for this glorious UU experience. There is an early bird discount that ends today, May 15th, and there are volunteer opportunities to help lower costs as well. So see this Gonzalez family, the Sant'Angelo May family, the Mann family, the Barkley family, the DeMorris family, the Jens Rocco family, or Rev Amy, or anyone in a Susie t-shirt for more information. And our groups are starting and restarting. With our opening of an office and meeting space in Davie, we're delighted to announce that we'll resume our monthly drum circle and welcome table communion and the formation of the Good Grief Support Group for bereavement support for losses of any kind at any time. Join us this week for the Good Grief Group on Tuesday evening and the Welcome Table Communion Circle on Thursday evening. For more information on any or all of these groups, contact Rev Amy at minister@riverofbrassuu.org. That's minister@riverofbrassuu.org. And today is a special day. We're having our River of Brass annual meeting today after service at 12:30. You all received an email with the agenda items that we'll be voting on and a link to the meeting. So grab yourself a quick bite and we'll see you then. Please refer to the weekly email for all other announcements. Thank you.
And yes, we will get rolling on that annual meeting about 12:15. So grab yourself a snack, refresh your coffee, and we'll see you back here. It passed by in the chat that Scott May was thanking all of the River of Brass folks who worked on the Stamp Out Hunger Drive, postal food drive yesterday. And also thanks to the River of Brass folks who got in the street and preached with their feet at the Women's Rally for Reproductive Rights in Fort Lauderdale yesterday. There were actions all over the continent. Proud we're part of it. Later in this annual meeting that we have, we will be voting on adopting the eighth principle. It is being discussed all over Unitarian Universalism. It will be voted on at an upcoming General Assembly for the entire association, but congregations are also one by one adopting it for their principle. We'll be voting for it later. We'll be talking about it a little bit more. Right now, we'd like to hear from Tanya, who's on our eighth principle team that's been working all year to help us understand what it is we're looking at here and why it is we need to make this part of our mission. Tanya?
Good morning. The eighth principle that we are considering adopting reads, journeying towards spiritual wholeness by working to build a diverse, multicultural, beloved community by our actions that accountably dismantle racism and other oppressions in ourselves and our institutions. Cedric Lofton was a 17-year-old Black teenager who died while in custody of law enforcement in Kansas in September of 2021. A Kansas district attorney announced on January 18th this year that he will be filing no charges in connection with Cedric Lofton's death. Lofton died after being handcuffed and restrained in the prone position, meanwhile face down, for over 30 minutes during a struggle with staff and corrections employees at a juvenile facility. The Kansas district attorney said at a news conference that the employees involved acted in self-defense under the state's robust Stand Your Ground law. An autopsy report found in December that Lofton's cause of death was complications of cardiopulmonary arrest sustained after physical struggle while restrained in the prone position. The medical examiner ruled the death a homicide. Because yet another unarmed Black teenager was killed while restrained face down on the ground, and it is being called self-defense, today, this is why I will vote to adopt the eighth principle for our congregation.
This morning on Thank You Sunday, we would like to thank the Eighth Principle Task Force, who has moved us through this year of study. We would like to thank all of you who attended discussions, who came to dinners, you who hosted dinners in your home, so that we could explore the ways we move forward in our crucial work for justice in our time, of which the Eighth Principle is a part. Thank you, Eighth Principle team. Thank you, River of Grass, for your participation all year long to bring us to this moment.
You didn't have to do what you did, but you did, but you did.
No, you didn't, but you did. And we don't know what we would have done if you hadn't.
So we thank you.
We sustain and strengthen this beloved community and its work in our world through the gifts of our time, our skills, our love, and our money. Each Sunday, half of our undesignated offerings go to LifeNet for Families, which provides meals, clothing, and support for those in need here in Broward County. The other half supports our mission and ministry at River of Grass. You'll find several ways to give at our River of Grass donate page at the link on the screen and in the chat. You can text to give at any time, or contact our office to set up convenient automated contributions. By whatever method best for you, please give generously and joyfully, that we may feed and fortify this congregation and its good work in the world.
Today's wisdom tale is about a tree that grows on a bridge in the Florida Keys. The tree's name is Fred. How did Fred the tree get his name, and why is he so special? Our author and illustrator Lee Guest will tell us about it. Way down south in the Florida Keys, above the ocean lives a tree. How can a tree live above the sea? He grows on a bridge quite happily. The tree has a name, and his name is Fred, and his home is the old 7-mile bridge. How did Fred get there? Many believe that a bird flying over dropped down his seed. Fred stands alone as this bridge has closed down. But cars on the new bridge driving through town can see Fred quite clearly and pass with a smile. "Hello, Fred," they say. "He has been there a while." So many love Fred, he has all types of friends. The osprey say hi and they rest on his limbs. The fish swimming under jump high in the air. It's their way of saying, "Hello, Fred, we care." The sun and the moon in the sky high above shine down on old Fred as they send down their love. Even the sharks swimming by in the sea shake their fins and look up at dear old Fred the tree. Fish, bird, and shark, moon, sun, and stars, child, adult, and passenger cars. The boats and the fishermen sailing below all love old Fred, and they wave a hello. In the Keys, they have storms of the mightiest kind that are made of wind and water combined. Monstrous and fast, they are called hurricanes. A giant one formed, and Irma was her name. She blew and she barged and she ripped through the Keys. People fled for their lives. She was big and angry. Cars drove away, families left in crowds. The sun and the moon even hid behind clouds. Fish fled to mangroves, birds flew their nests, sharks hid down deep, boats left their nets. But Fred had to stay. He had nowhere to go. He held on to his roots, and he faced her alone. Homes were destroyed. Trees were knocked down. Toys, dolls, and teddy bears washed out of town. Beaches were ruined. Sand washed away. Fred saw it all, and at times was afraid. Irma was big, but old Fred was brave. She pushed and she shoved. But Fred would not cave. He struggled and fought, kept on till the end. His home was the Keys, and he loved all his friends. He knew they would need him, so he held on tight. When his friends returned home, they saw Fred had survived. "If Fred can survive, so can we," they all said. He lifted their spirits. The people loved Fred. You can see there, they have signs that say, "Go, Fred. We love Fred. Welcome home," Fred said. So homes were repaired. Sharks left the deep. The fish and the mangroves swam back to the reef. Birds made new nests. Boats fixed their bows. And the sun and the moon returned from the clouds. The Keys were rebuilt. It didn't take long. Just like Fred, his friends were Keys strong. "Thank you," they said to old Fred the tree, "for standing up to Irma. We need you in the Keys." In December, his friends climb up ladders from boats with Christmas lights and twinkling ropes. They decorate Fred for his fans to see. In the Keys, they love Fred. Dear old Fred, the tree. And that is the story of Fred, who lives on the old 7-mile bridge. If you go to the Keys, say hello to old Fred, for he's a survivor, a hero, a friend. And that is the story of Fred the Tree.
Don't be discouraged. Don't give up now. Really, preacher? Really? On yet another Sunday morning, after yet another tragedy rooted in racism, anti-Semitism, and queer hatred, white supremacy. Another community, another 11 families torn apart with Ukraine and the rapidly melting ice caps and rising poverty and debt and no baby formula. Really, preacher, where do we even start? Don't be discouraged. Don't give up now. Well, you know, the text for this service was set a while back. But now it means more. Now it goes deeper. This text is from the 8th century, before the current era. This text is 2,700 years old. This text is the word of the prophet Isaiah from the Hebrew scriptures. The prophet proclaims unto us. We are called to preach good tidings unto the meek. We are called to bind up the brokenhearted.
We are called to proclaim liberty to captives and open the prisons to them that are bound. We are called to give unto them that mourn beauty for ashes, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness. And they shall build the old wastes, they shall raise up the former desolations, and they shall repair the wasted cities, the desolations of many generations. To give beauty for ashes. Beauty for ashes. What an image to ponder. What a concept to contemplate here as we consider the state of this world and the state of this congregation's service in it, to it, and for it. As we gather up the data and discernments of this past year to consider what it all means in this moment of our history as a people, as a congregation, as citizens, as neighbors, as families, as Unitarian Universalists, as a human family, as we are called to serve a world so broken, and yet also so beautiful. To build a new way, a new day on the ashes of the old. As we witness institutions so many of us believed were trustworthy crack and crumble before our eyes, the norms and mores of civil society, the basic standards of human decency violated in some of the most evil ways. And now not only do we see how fragile, how shallow those institutional roots have been all along, we wake up to the reality that they only ever seemed sturdy to those in privilege. As our Black and Brown and Indigenous and Asian and LGBTQ and disabled and mentally ill and non-Christian and all of our kin clinging to the margins of our society have been trying to tell us for hundreds of years, in the face of the perpetual myth of meritocracy and the work ethic of the Puritans and the golden calf called individualism that insists that if anybody just tries hard enough, if anybody just works long enough, they too can be rich, like the ones who rant and rave they did it all on their own. First of all, nobody does anything all on their own. And least of all, those who are endowed with privilege by want of generational wealth, social position, access to education, along with the color of their skin, shape of their eyes, their able bodies, their heteronormative identity and orientation, American accent, and Christian traditions. How loudly we keen and wail. How did we get here? Well, we're learning more and more and more about that and about our part in it, whether we knew it or not. And while that learning and unlearning is essential and existential, if we are to stop repeating all that history again and again and again, it is equally essential and existential for us to ask beyond how did we get here, to ask the question, where do we go from here? And how? And while that is the global question for our planet, our continent, our nation, it is more essentially the question for us as a people, as a community, as a congregation of Unitarian Universalists called River of Grass. Where do we go from here? How do we raise up the former desolations, to repair the waste cities, the desolations of many generations? How shall we give beauty for ashes. Years ago, a determined bunch of people dreamed up an outpost of progressive Unitarian Universalist religion in western Broward County and named it River of Grass. As with any dream, the way before them was strewn with both triumphs and tribulations, the kind of tribulations that by all rights should have stopped them for good at any of several turns. Indeed, for most young congregations, at any one of those old tribulations, they would most likely have sent River of Grass into a footnote in the history of Unitarian Universalism in South Florida. But no, not this lot, not this bunch. Some of them here with us this morning. This bunch would not be dissuaded. And so here we are in 2022, churned again in tribulation in the world and in our communities and in ourselves, in the deepest cauldron of chaos in our lifetimes. And we are still here, still believing in the power of this remarkable Unitarian Universalist faith, still holding to the bonds of community, still working for the world that we dream of, still determined to build a new way of love that never dies and hope that never quits for a new world in our time. And from the beginning, there's been a song to help remind us of who we are and why we are here, and that none of us is in this alone.
That you're all you've got, and don't feel alone anymore. 'Cause when we're together, then you've got a lot. 'Cause I am the river, and you are the shore. And it goes on and on, watching the river run further and further from things that we've done, leaving them one by one, and we have just begun watching the river run, listening and learning and yearning to run, river run. Swirling and dancing along, we pass by the old willow tree. Where lovers caress as we sing them our song, rejoicing together as we greet the sea. And it goes on and on, watching the river run. Further and further from things that we've done, leaving them one by one, and we have just begun watching the river run, listening and learning and yearning to run, river run, and we have just begun. Listening and learning and yearning
Run, river, run.
Listening and learning and yearning to run, river, run. Years ago, the prophet Isaiah proclaimed unto us that we are called to preach good tidings, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty, to build the old wastes and raise up the former desolations, to become trees of righteousness like Fred, holding fast out there on the old 7-mile bridge in a raging storm, to give beauty for ashes. 23 years ago, a new gathering of Unitarian Universalists called River of Grass took up that call. As we go forward from this day, we gather again in a few moments to consider the future of this River of Grass Unitarian Universalist congregation for the coming year and for the generations to come. We affirm again that we are not called just to survive 26 months, 791 days of pandemic and upheaval and rude awakenings for nothing, but to challenge us again to take up that call, that ancient, ancient call. Oh no, we are called to preach the good word of Unitarian Universalism for our time, that we might serve to repair the desolations of many generations. It is not an overstatement to say that the future of Unitarian Universalism in our place and in our time is at stake. My beloveds, don't be discouraged. Don't give up now. Let us come and bind up the brokenhearted and our own broken hearts, that we might proclaim liberty and raise up former desolations. Let us run, river, run, and dedicate ourselves once more to give beauty for ashes.
There will be better days. There will be better days. There will be better days. There will be better days.
There will be better days.
There will be better days. There will be better days. There will be better days.
Let the wave wash over me.
There will be better days. There will be better days.
I am
there will be better days.
As we release this flame from its faithful service today, we allow the spark in each of us to burn on, to warm our compassion, to fire our delight, and light our paths today, tomorrow, and always.
In these changing times, let us keep our eyes on a vision of a world transformed and dare to transform ourselves to make it so. Until we meet again, shine on.